We have studied till the last of the Tughlaq rulers, when Firoz Shah Tughlaq was a ruler who took up the welfare activities. After him was a weak ruler, Muhammad Nasiruddin, and under him there was a Mongol attack by Timur, who came to India from, who was a Central Asian Mongol. And in 1398, after the invasion of Timur, it was Timur who appointed Khizr Khan as his deputy in India. Till there we had finished up the last, and with Khizr Khan began the Lodi dynasty. I would like to begin now the Lodi dynasty. Bahlol Lodi was the first ruler of the Lodi dynasty. He appointed loyal Afghan nobles as governors of important provinces. His sultanate stretched from Punjab to Bihar. After his death, his son Sikandar Lodi proved to be a very capable ruler. He brought Jaunpur and Bihar under his control. He introduced many public welfare measures. He was succeeded by Ibrahim Lodi, who was the last ruler of the Lodi dynasty. Ibrahim Lodi ascended the throne in AD 1517. He failed to gain the support of Afghan nobles. Finally, Daulat Khan Lodi invited Babur, the ruler of Kabul, to invade India and overthrow Ibrahim Lodi. Babur, with an army of 10,000, defeated Ibrahim Lodi in the First Battle of Panipat in 1526. With the defeat of Ibrahim Lodi, the Delhi Sultanate finally came to an end. Here I have the Sayyid dynasty in detail, where we just need to know the reign of Khizr Khan. He was the first among the Sayyids, followed by Mubarak Shah. Then it was Muhammad Shah. He was the nephew of Mubarak Shah. And then Alauddin Alam Shah Sayyid. He was lost to Bahlol Lodi in 1451. And with that came the Sayyid dynasty came to an end. And then began the Lodi dynasty. And among the Lodis, the first ruler was Bahlol Lodi, followed by Sikandar Lodi, and then Ibrahim Lodi. Now, for Bahlol Lodi, we just need to know the year. He was the first of the Lodi rulers to start the dynasty. And after that, things we need to know about him is appointed loyal Afghan nobles as governors and important provinces. Then Sultanate under him stretched from Punjab to Haryana. That means it had a lasting effect. Then Sikandar Lodi, he was an able and capable person. All we need to know is he brought Jaunpur and Bihar under his rule, and he was also famous for his public affairs, the public welfare measures he took up. Then we lastly talk of Ibrahim Lodi. About him, we know that he failed to gain the support of the Afghan nobles. And Daulat Khan Lodi invited Babur, who was a ruler of Kabul, to overthrow Ibrahim Lodi in the First Battle of Panipat, which was fought in 1526. And with this, the Delhi Sultanate came to an end. So all we need to know about is that Ibrahim Lodi, while he was ruling, he was betrayed by this Daulat Khan Lodi, who invited Babur, who was living in Kabul, and he invited Babur to come and fight a battle with Ibrahim Lodi. So First Battle of Panipat was fought in 1526 between Ibrahim Lodi and Babur, in which Ibrahim Lodi was defeated and Babur came to power. And with coming of Babur in India, it began the Mughal rule in India. With that began the Mughal rule in India, about which you'll read in the third chapter.